the first and foremost number one priority you should have when getting ready to use an Instant Pot or a multi-cooker is read the directions.
The executive chef at the Culinary Center of Kansas City, Jill Garcia Schmidt, says pressure cookers give you word-for-word directions to keep you safe. But according to some lawsuits and a recent post on social media, some people say they are dangerous and gave them second and third degree burns.
Steam is past the boiling point in order to get to make steam. So you're talking anywhere from 180 degrees and up. And once it's been going for, you know, an hour or so, it can be anywhere from 300 degrees or more. And that's third degree burn temperatures if you're not careful.
One social media post from October comes from a woman who says she did follow the directions. She checked the pressure valve, saw there was no steam releasing, and unlocked her pressure cooker. She describes how she lifted up the lid and that the soup shot up like a rocket and exploded all over her. She was covered in second degree burns and is now warning others. But Schmidt says this can be avoided. She says you have two options when the buzzer to the steaming valve goes off.
To either release the steam manually or let it sit for about 15 to 20 minutes, which will be recommended per recipe. It'll allow the steam to release naturally. And then when you release the steam valve, instead of it going up like a geyser, it'll just kind of be a little more of a calm situation, and you don't have to worry about that lid flying off.
She also recommends keeping your face, hands, arms, and any skin away from the steam valve.
I never use my fingers to do that. I always grab a wooden spoon or some sort of utensil with a long handle so that I can actually stand back from the Instant Pot and flick that sucker off.
She says to make sure you're knowledgeable before you even plug it in.
If you don't know what you're doing before you get this item, then you need to educate yourself.
Melissa Stern, Fox 4 News.